some games in their cases, but the games we actually play or want to show people, we put here. Also, this is not the entirety of our games, because we have digital games, of course, virtual console, or just eShop exclusive digital only titles. So what's in this binder doesn't represent the whole collection, and I'm thinking of doing a video where we some Wii games in here, I think. So you'll see some Wii games. But you'll see some important Wii U games, Wii U must-haves, are missing from here. Namely, Mario Maker, Splatoon, Bayonetta 2. I don't know if there's something else, but there's reasons why those games are missing. Mario Maker, for example. When the game first came out, I actually borrowed it. And, well, first of all, I don't enjoy building levels in games. I'm not a Minecraft or any of these tinkering games. Type games where you build. So I wasn't too enthusiastic about Mario Maker from the beginning, but I borrowed it for a long time from a friend near its release within a couple months. And that was back when people didn't really know how to make good levels to share, and also it was before any updates, so there was some really important stuff that hadn't come out yet, items and in-game things, and also the better online sharing, bookmarking and following, rating. So all that stuff hadn't come out when I borrowed it, and I borrowed it for weeks and didn't really get into it, so I didn't buy it for a while. When I finally saw all those great updates, I really wanted to get back into it and try some levels, but I thought I'll wait till the price comes down, and the price never came down and kept never coming down. And then Switch started becoming a lot closer and a lot more real, so I just thought I'd just wait and get in on Mario Maker when it comes around for Switch. So that's what I'm doing. We'll see what they do with Mario Maker. They haven't mentioned anything yet. With Splatoon, I'm not a big, these kind of first-person arena-type game, I'm not a big fan, so it was easy to talk myself out of it. But I did promise myself that if there was a re-release or a sequel, I would get in on that, so at the start, day one. So I'm going to do that with Switch. I'll get in this summer. respect Platinum Games. As you see, I have Wonderful 101, and I've enjoyed their games in the past. Beautiful Joe was a favorite on GameCube. But Bayonetta was just too mature for my tastes, if you know what I mean. So, the language and some of the visuals and things, so... but I do recognize its importance, like I said, and I would like to feel the gameplay sometime. So maybe if there's a re-release of that, I'll give it a try. So this case, this disc binder, is a Case Logic binder, and I really like it. As you can see, it's got a hard shell and it's high quality, thick, strong zipper. Doesn't feel like it's aged at all. We've been using it for years, almost daily. It's in great shape. Wasn't expensive. I'd buy another one if I needed to hold together this 24 discs. For some reason, I'd buy them. And yeah, it holds 24, I think, discs. And I've got 23 discs in here. And having one empty one is killing my daughters. They really feel like we need to have the 24th disc. So, if you can recommend a Wii or Wii U game that won't come out on Switch, that can fill that last spot, let me know. So, Mario and Sonic at the Rio 2016 Olympics. My daughters are big into gymnastics and the Olympics in general, and so they really, really, really wanted this game, so we basically got it for them. I play it sometimes with them, but other than that, I haven't played it. But it's basically a collection of mini games, and it's fun. It looks fantastic and sounds even better. The music in this game is incredible. whatever I could and saw everything I could and got through it. And the ending is incredible. The last chapter is just a blast. It's hilarious. And Monster Hunter, I love this game. Played it for a long time. And a Monster Hunter on Switch is one of my most anticipated games. What my favorite game I ever played on my Wii U was, you would say Xenoblade easily. I put nearly 200 hours into that game, and I really loved the experience. I'm not a huge anime or mech fan, although I do watch Japanese animation cartoons. Stranger to it, but like it wasn't that drew me to the game. I'm not necessarily big into complex RPGs either, or action RPGs, but man, the game world in that game, the music, the atmosphere, the environment, the mechs were cool, of course, and the customization and the enemies, the variety, I was just huge, never-ending fun. Rhythm Heaven Fever. One of my daughters is demolishing this game and only has a few more medals to get before 100% completion. So, we love this game. It's a lot of fun in the house. We love to laugh with it and pretend we're like in the game. Good stuff. The Legend of Zelda, The Wind Waker, and Pikmin 3. I think this HD remake is, as far as HD remakes go, it's a masterpiece. It's so well done. I was thoroughly impressed through 100% of the game. The visuals and the music are just, they're just incredible. I constantly find myself popping this game in just for like a 10-minute dose of the visuals and the sounds. Designed in the history of video games ever. Setting, that kind of old Japan. I really love the story concept, but for some reason, unfortunately, I couldn't get into the controls, the gameplay itself, the fighting, the battles, the motion of the paint stuff. And it was really unfortunate because I loved so much about the game, but we leave it here in the case because people do like to pop it in and play around. So, new Super Mario Brothers U, new Super Luigi U. I love this game. I 100% did both Mario U and Luigi U, and I completed most of those bonus missions or whatever they're called. And it's such a great challenge, and it feels classic and new at the same time, and quality game. City Folk and The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD. Animal Crossing City Folk, I tried getting into that. It wasn't my style, but my daughters love it a lot and they still play it. You know how you do Animal Crossing, just keep checking in forever and ever. So they still play that. Legend of Zelda, Twilight Princess HD. I do like Twilight Princess, and so of course I do like it in HD. I don't think it's as great of an HD remaster. Do you call it a remaster or a port or whatever? As Wind Waker, which is unfortunate. I understand someone else did this HD remaster as opposed to Nintendo, who did Wind Waker, and I think you can tell. Donkey Kong Country, Tropical Freeze, and Captain Toad, Treasure Tracker. These two are way high up on my favorite Wii U games. I absolutely games. Excellent experiences that can't be had anywhere else. Lovely, lovely games, and I've done individual videos for them both already, so you can hear me gushing about how much I love them in those videos. Speed, Most Wanted U, and Harvest Moon, Animal Parade, this game here, Need for Speed. I dug the soundtrack. It got me hyped up during races. I loved becoming the most wanted driver. I love the open world and all the different things you could find and little places to get into. Just a great game. I loved customizing cars. I like the controls and yeah, I really appreciated this game. I would really love another open world, open city racing game in this vein for Switch. I'm hoping for it, looking forward to something like it. I do like racing games in general. I dig the futuristic racers or even like jet ski, wave race style or anything of that nature, but that open world city one really hit the spot for me. In Harvest Moon, my daughters still play this. I think my oldest like did almost everything you can do in the game, which is crazy because it just seems like it never ends, but she still checks back in every once in a while and plays for a while, so she keeps it going. But she's already married and has a kid and did all, collected all the bells, of course, and she's deep, pretty deep. Yoshi's Woolly World and Lego City Undercover. Yoshi's Woolly World is the newest to this collection. I just bought this recently, and I haven't even finished playing it yet, so I will make a video of the game individually when I finish it, give my memories of it, my feelings and thoughts, but so far it's great, great fun, and it's a high quality game, and I'm really enjoying it. Is a lot, because there is a lot to collect in this game, but it's just a feel-good kind of hangout kind of game. You get some chuckles, some giggles out of it, and just kind of a relaxed gaming experience, so good time. Assassin's Creed 4, Black Flag, and Scribblenauts Unlimited. I enjoyed Black Flag. I'm glad I'm the kind of player who I like to collect a lot as I go. I don't plow through the story and then collect afterward, because by the time I finished the story, I had collected, I had, you know, a lot of the map was complete. And I had defeated a couple of the legendary ships by the time I completed the story, and I'm glad I did, because as soon as I finished the story, I lost interest in collecting anything anymore, so I had a good experience because of that, thankfully, luckily, and it was great. My daughters watched me play, and it was like an epic movie, and we kept wanting to know who's next. It was good stuff. And Scribblenauts, I barely played this game, almost not at all. My daughters played this one, and they beat it, and they seemed to have a good time. I watched them play a little while, and it was good fun. Little King's Story in Just Dance 2015. I have a sad story with Little King's Story. I got very, very far into it. And I put a lot of hours into it. And one day, saved. And this was after I had put hours and hours and hours into the game. I was deep into the game. But this one day I played and hadn't saved, and then the game froze. It's the only time the game ever did that. The game froze. So of course I lost everything I had done that day I was playing, and I haven't been able to pick it up since, and I lost so much that day that, yeah. And Just Dance 2015 is another exercise game for my wife. And the blank page, the empty.